Work Manager provides a set of APIs that make it easy to schedule asynchronous tasks for immediate or deferred execution that are expected to run even if the app is closed or the device restarts. For Kotlin users, Work Manager provides first-class support for coroutines. In this video, you learn the basics of Work Manager with coroutines by building on the Work Manager code lab. So let's get started. The Work Manager library is the recommended choice for any task that should continue to run even if the user navigates away from that particular screen, if the user puts the application in background, or if the device restarts. So common tasks could be uploading logs or reporting data, applying filters to images or saving the image, or periodically syncing local data with the network. But if your immediate task can end when the user leaves a certain scope, so if the task should end when the user leaves a screen, then you should not use Work Manager. This is a place where you should use Kotlin coroutines directly. Okay, getting back to our colab. The Work Manager colab blurs an image and saves the result on disk. So let's see what was needed to achieve this. We added the work runtime KTX dependency. This brings a couple of Kotlin extension functions and coroutine support. We started then by implementing our own worker class. This is where we put the code for the actual work you want to perform in the background. You'll extend the worker class and override the doWork method. As this is the most important class, we'll go over it in detail a little bit later. Then we build our work request. In our case, we want to perform the work only once, so we use a one-time work request filter. As input, we set the URI of the image we want to blur. And here's a Kotlin tip. To create the input data, use the workDataOf function that creates the data builder, puts the key value pair, and creates the data for us. To schedule the work and make it run, we use the Work Manager class. We can provide tasks to be done and constraints to these tasks. When you use a worker, Work Manager automatically calls worker do work on a background thread. The result returned from do work informs the Work Manager service whether the work succeeded, and in case of failure, whether or not the work should be retried. Worker do work is a synchronous call. You're expected to do the entirety of your background work in a blocking fashion and finish it by the time the method exits. If you call an asynchronous API in do work and return a result, your callback might not operate properly. Okay, but what if we do want to do asynchronous work? Let's complicate our example and say that we want to save the URIs of all the files that have been blurred in the database. So for this, I extended the collab and created a simpler blurred image entity, a DAW class to insert and get images, and the database. If you have to do asynchronous work, like saving data in the database or doing network requests, in Kotlin, we recommend using a coroutine worker. A coroutine worker allows us to do asynchronous work using Kotlin coroutines. The doWork method is a suspend method, so this means that we can easily call our suspending DAO call here. By default, doWork uses dispatchers.default. You can override this with the dispatcher that you need. In our case, we don't need to do this because Room already moves the insert work on a different dispatcher. Check out the Room Kotlin API's math skills video for more details. And that was it. That is how we used Work Manager to blur images and save their URIs in the database. So start using Coroutine Worker to perform asynchronous work that needs to complete even if the user closes your app. If you want to learn more about Work Manager, stay tuned for a future series dedicated to covering it in depth. Until then, check out our collabs and documentation linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.